So people ask me all the time, people ask me all the time, like, why did I stop believing that Black Lives, shouldn't matter? And it's not that I don't believe that Black Lives shouldn't matter. It's just the fact that I'm removing myself personally from the movement. I'm removing myself from the movement itself or anything really tied to the movement. But for me personally, I still do believe that, Black lives do matter. I mean, I do believe that, Black people's lives should matter. That there's many people in the world that their lives should matter, including the Black community, people in the Black community. So, it's not the fact that it's not the fact that I don't believe that Black people's lives shouldn't matter. It's the fact that I feel like there's a lot of controversy in a lot of these, racial groups, whether it's Black Lives Matter, whether it's All Lives Matter, or anything at this point that related to race or what I consider to be a racial divide and stuff like that. I just don't want to put myself in any type of political party that has to do with race, whether even if it's Black Lives and Black people are saying Black Lives is the way to go. I just kind of want to put myself out of it. And I've talked to my I've had a counselor. Before my counselor retired, I was talking to my mental health therapist and counselor, and I talked to him about that. I talked to him that yes, he knew that I understood that, he understood that I'm not really a racist or nothing, and I actually do like Black people and the Black community, and I actually do think that Black lives do people, if a Black person's life should matter. But when it comes to these racial groups and all these divisions with like Black lives and stuff like that, I've had a lot of issues trying to connect with people on black and on the terms of Black lives, and a lot of people a lot of connecting with a lot of people on the terms of like as far as like the groups and the movements that people are a part of. And I see it having more serious consequences for where it doesn't really need to have more serious consequences or more serious, outlooks of problems because of how it's being, how it's being treated or how the situation is being handled. So, because I don't need to be, something to be said like I'm one way when I'm really not that way, and I'm really, maybe, probably more on the positive side of supporting Black lives. And then, some people are trying to, make it seem like I'm not, because some people are really trying to test the waters to see how worthy or how far I will go to prove that I'm supposed to be part of Black lives and stuff like that, granted that some of these people were also people that I got into an issue with before because I wanted to say that all lives mattered. But that also came from my counselor that also retired, because me and him were having a conversation about how a lot of people thought I was too caught up in racial issues, and a lot of people think I'm too caught up in racial issues with race and stuff like that, with like Black Lives Matter and stuff like that, and I'm not necessarily even black, A lot of people thought I was caught up in all these racial issues and stuff because I was trying to, support the Black community and show my support to the Black community, because I believe that, I wanted to believe that, I wanted to kind of believe in that, and I also wanted to believe in that so I could also show people in the Black community that I actually stood by them. So hopefully I could, maybe. Now it was also in a personal manner too, that I also wanted to, it also was also because I'm attracted to Black men and Black women, and for me personally, it was like I wanted to be a part of it also, to also show that I'm here for you, and I'm also sticking by you, but I also like you at the same time. But a lot of people are not, in the Black community for, Black Lives Matter and stuff like that, are not for interracial relationships, Or a lot of, some people think it's very taboo and very like, no, you can't do it. So, that's my like, no, you can't do it. But, but regardless of the factor, it's like, I but still believe in interracial relationships. I still believe that, I could still have a chance of loving a, a Black woman or a Black man and still be in a relationship, and their life will matter to me, because they would be my life partner, and why wouldn't their life matter to me, and stuff like that. So, But, you know, at the same time, it's like all these racial groups and all these racial divisions and stuff were not are not really the greatest. And the whole All Lives Matter thing that kind of created a whole big tension thing was kind of said to me through a counselor who obviously wasn't well educated enough before the whole thing blew up, where the whole thing blew up and said, or the whole thing got popular, where it said, Black lives are supposed to matter, you know. When that whole situation got popular and stuff, that, my counselor didn't know it until after the fact that things got popular, that Black lives were supposed to matter, and Black Lives Matter was supposed to be, the way to go. And according to him, he didn't know better. He didn't know better until it actually became popular into more of a groundbreaking front row center thing. But for me, I was always supporting it. I was supporting it back in 2016, 2017. I was actually wearing, Black Lives Matter tank tops and shirts, and I was supporting it. And some people thought I was like, I got a lot of comments in town, in this town, saying, a lot of people saying to me, "All lives matter" and stuff like that. Why are you wearing the Black Lives Matter stuff and stuff like that? And I felt very much like an outcast. Are very much like I was supporting Black Lives Matter, and I was really the only one in the town that was gonna do it, granted that then when I finally kind of just, granted then when I was finally having a counseling session, telling my counselor basically about the fact that I, some people thought I was too caught up in racial issues and stuff like that, that he kind of told me that, why don't you believe in All Lives Matter? Where do you think you are? Where do you see yourself, or where do you stand? And it's like, well, as soon as we started talking about the All Lives Matter thing, he kind of started telling me about All Lives Mattering and stuff like that. And of course, according to him, he ended the session not being able to tell me that Black lives still matter. But I think that's his way of just covering his ass, because he really kind of told me that all lives matter, and that's what I should try, and that's what I should actually, try to maybe, be a part of, instead of maybe Black lives, if there really was an issue. So that was actually my counselor that actually had said that. So that's kind of his fault, but granted, later on he changed his tune when the whole thing, when Black Lives Matter took front and center, and like all the political rallies and stuff like that. So, he kind of changed his tune and said, "Oh, that's where the majority is thinking right now, and that's where the majority of the world is now thinking is culturally correct or culturally acceptable that Black Lives Matter." But I still think there's a lot of controversy in Black Lives Matter, I still think there's a lot of controversy in Black Lives Matter. I still don't like the way some as a white person that you get treated, for maybe not knowing all the facts or not knowing everything about how to go about supporting Black Lives Matter and stuff like that. Sorry, I got reflux issues and stuff like that about learning, how about supporting Black Lives Matter. And so I was made to look like a fool one day. Obviously I went back to those same people who, had heard me say All Lives Matter at one point, thanks to my counselor and his fucking counseling thing, where he does that thing where he can't tell you what to believe in, but then he's trying to tell you what to believe in. So you assume he's trying to tell you to believe in one thing, and it's like, it blew up out of proportion. And obviously a lot of people from, Hartford and stuff like that got really mad at me and stuff like that, because, I started saying, all lives matter and stuff like that, and really it was supposed to be Black Lives Matter. But regardless of what matters, whether it's all lives, Black lives, yellow lives, Asian lives, Indian lives, I don't, who knows? But, for the most part, it's I'm at that point where I just want to stay away from all of the, all of these, group, all of these, groups that I just, I'm sorry I kind of got involved. I mean, there's some people out there in the world who don't get involved in all these political groups like Black Lives Matter or All Lives Matter and stuff like that. And, you know, they tend to be more peaceful and more content with themselves for not trying to get involved in any of those racial, you know, controversial issues. They tend to be more, you know, content with themselves and the direction of their lives, you know. Actually, I met a girl from New York probably about a year ago. This girl from New York told me she didn't actually believe in Black Lives, and she was actually a black woman. She told me she didn't believe in Black Lives Matter because she feels like people who got, you know, there's a lot of people in Black Lives Matter still getting away with a lot of crimes and stuff like that, and then they're, you know, what they want to protest for and what they want to represent is not always seen as, you know, politically correct and stuff like that, because some of those people are still very guilty of the crimes and things they commit. So that's how she was feeling. You know, that's how she was feeling. So for me personally, I mean, I still say that black people's lives should matter. You know, black people's lives should matter, and I'm still gonna go about treating people, you know, like black people's lives should matter. It's just the fact that I'm not gonna put a label on it saying, you know, Black Lives Matter and stuff like that, because I've known of some people, and I know of some people who've gotten attached to that group and those organizations and stuff, and some of them just didn't treat me well. Some of them were friends of friends. Some of them were like other poets and other artists and friends of friends who did not treat me well or did not treat me with respect, you know? Obviously some people are going to say I don't deserve it because I got white privilege and I'm a white person and all this other stuff, but, you know, respect is earned, not given, yes, but at the same time, you know, it's like, you can't respect me because why? Because society is built on a white privilege and, you know, I'm supposed to be a white person and, you know, whatever, you know. But regardless of the factor, you know, I'm removing myself out of all these political, you know, Black Lives Matter groups, All Lives Matter, and I'm removing myself from all of them. I was actually going to probably about a month or two ago, and I was going to about a month or two ago, and then I met this guy online who obviously had an infatuation with me. This guy Rashid or whatever his name is had this huge infatuation with me, you know. Didn't even really know me, and was starting to tell me he loved me over our video chat and stuff like that, and I kind of broke up with him, and he kind of just started rubbing it in my face, like I'm like being harassment and being kind of really abusive, and I decided to just block him and cut it off and not talk to him again. But hopefully he's not going to stalk me now for it. But this guy kind of had, like, you know, this like infatuation obsession with me a little bit, but for the most part, I'm doing what I need to do, and I'm just chilling, you know, and, you know, but when I was in a relationship with him, I had went on this whole spiel that, you know, why do black lives not matter? Why does his life not matter? Why, you know, his life matters to me. Why does his life not matter and stuff like that? And it's true. The person if I was seeing a black person or a person, you know, of the black community for an actual relationship, why wouldn't their life not matter to me? Why wouldn't their life not matter to me? Why wouldn't a black person's life not matter to me now, right? But at the same time, it's just all this controversial issues has been really affecting my mental health, you know? My mental health, all this back and forth and all these controversial issues and all this stuff that I've gone through over the last few years, that my mental health is kind of at jeopardy for, you know, trying to get involved with black lives, trying to get involved with all lives, trying to get involved with all these, you know. I've learned the hard way for trying to get involved with all lives, which all lives kicked me out of their groups. And Black Lives, obviously, is having a hard time even accepting me into theirs as well. So it's like, you know. So at this point, it's like, you know, I'm at that point where I'm like, you know, even if I wanted to say Black Lives Matter, I mean, I'm obviously not welcome in some people's Black Lives Matter group. And I definitely wasn't welcome in the All Lives Matter group because I started talking about Black Lives Mattering because I wanted to believe a black person's life would matter. And a lot of people had issues with that. So I'm at the point now where I'm staying out of these political groups and all this controversial issues and stuff like that because I don't really want to get, you know, involved with too much of this, you know, racial dramas or political dramas and stuff like that. And I'm going to try to do what I need to do to try to just better, you know, better myself and, you know, try to better my own background, in my own, I don't even know what I'm going to do, but I'm going to try to better myself for foremost and foremost, but, you know, I'm at that point where I'm not even sure. You know, I think at this point, you know, I've tried to embrace the black community. I've tried to embrace the black culture. I've tried to, you know, support the black culture through Black Lives Matter and stuff like that. But at this point, I want to just support my own. You know, I want to support my own. And that's kind of where I'm at right now, where it's, you know, instead of, like, you know, having certain things in my house, I'm going to try to change a couple of things around. Like, you know, I know for a sure thing that I'm an Italian, right? I'm an Italian myself, so I know it's for a sure thing that I'm an Italian. There's a Latin origin to my last name, but it doesn't really say where my Latin origin comes from to my last name. It doesn't say what country. It just says there's a Latin Italian origin to my last name. So there may be some Latin, you know, some Latin Hispanic ancestry to my last name, but first and foremost, it's also Italian. So I'm going to embrace my Italian heritage by getting myself an Italian flag and taking down the Latin flag in my living room and embrace the Latin culture that is rightfully mine and rightfully tied to my last name that I should really be embracing and, you know, representing and, you know, and stuff like that. So, that's one of the things I'm going to do. And as far as any, you know, any of these political flags and stuff like that, I'm going to be removing my Black Lives Matter flag. I'm not going to get rid of my Black Lives Matter flag. There's always a chance I might want to bring it back out again or something, but I'm going to put my Black Lives Matter flag in the kit, you know, my Black Lives Matter flag away. My mom has, as I said before, my mom has a replacement flag for that, which is very similar to the Black Lives Matter flag design, but it's about faith, and the flag itself is about faith over fear, you know. The flag itself is about faith over fear, so, and it has, it's a Psalms from the Bible. It's like faith over fear or something like that, but it's a flag that my mom has that my mom actually let me order, and I told her, you know, I'd pay her back for it, which I still owe my mom over, like, $500, and there's no way how, I'm not even sure how I'm going to pay her back at this point, so, but I am, like, more and more, I tend to owe my mother, so, you know, but for the most part, I'm just chilling, I'm just doing what I need to do, and, I just think there's a lot of things going on with all these cultural groups that are affecting my mental health, and I really need to just, you know, back away. You know, it's not that I don't believe that a black person's life should matter. It's not that I don't believe that black women or black guys are attractive. It's just that I don't want to be tied to any of the movements anymore. despite what people might feel is politically correct, you know. I mean, I know some people might call me a traitor and stuff like that, but I'm not joining any other movements, you know. Regardless, I'm not joining any other movements. I'm trying to stay out of all these, you know, racial pride movements and stuff like that that are all kind of divisions of different, you know, racial groups that, you know, kind of conflict with the others, you know, or how some people might feel kind of conflict with the others. So, you know, but obviously the counselors, obviously, you know, counseling is very interesting. You know, they can hear you, but they can't really give advice, right? They can't give advice for counseling, but they can hear you out, and they can talk to you about what they think you might feel or what you might be bringing up in counseling. And, you know, obviously, it's not really advice what they give you. They're at least legally and clinically, it can't be advice, but, you know, obviously, they say things, and, you know, it gets taken the way it gets taken, and yeah, who gets in trouble for it? You do. They don't get in trouble for their shit that they tell you, or their shit if they tell you that all lives matter and shit like that, you know? I was the one who kind of got those repercussions and those issues because of my counselor saying all lives matter. Why don't I join all lives matter and shit like that because of some issues and some, you know, some situations like that. So, granted, this was over like two or three, four years ago, but for the most part, I mean, I was still trying to stick with Black Lives Matter because that's also what I truly wanted to believe in too. Is that we all mattered, and Black Lives Matter, you know, Black Lives also mattered. But you know, obviously, you know, one group thinks one is racist, and the other one thinks, you know, the other one is kind of racist, and everybody thinks racist. You know, everybody thinks all those. Well, no matter which one you're in, it's you think it's all racist. But regardless of the factor, you know, I'm staying out of, you know, political groups for my mental health. You know, I'm actually got rid of a bunch of Obama books. I had like a $50 Obama book I just gave away on my giveaway table downstairs in the community room, which I gave to a neighbor because I just had all, you know, I had some things like books on Obama. I had some books on Michelle Obama. I'm keeping a couple of them for now, but there's a lot of books I had about Obama, and there's a lot of political books I had from, like, you know, from the Obama administration, and, you know, more Democratic type of books that I'm trying to get rid of a lot of my political books because I'm not necessarily trying to be tied to too many political parties at this point. You know, as I said to many people, I'm not necessarily the far right. I'm not necessarily the far left. I'm not necessarily Democrat. I'm not necessarily Republican. I mean, I can vote Democrat or Republican, but I'm more independent, you know. But obviously, there's only so far you can go. You can either go Democrat, Republican, or independent, you know, and hope that the independent people can hold your views and hold some type of morals that you can vote for, you know, compared to a Republican or a Democrat, you know. So sometimes I often forget about the independents, but I am kind of independent, and I'm not really tied to a political party, you know. I'm not really tied to a political party, but I have been voting, you know, I have at times been voting Democrat, you know. I'm actually one of the reasons that Joe Biden got into office, because he had gotten my vote last election, you know. Where he stands now with this next election, who knows? You know, who knows what I'm gonna vote for, what I'm gonna do. But I might change my political vote. I might change my political opinion. You know, as of this year, you know, we don't know how this is gonna go yet. I'm trying to stay away from politics altogether for my mental health. But at the same time, I'm also a voter, and I also want to make my voice heard and my opinion heard. But sometimes it might be better, too, just to go vote and just keep your opinion to yourself and just go home and not tell anybody who you voted for, you know? Because as I said before in a post, you know, there's three issues that bring a lot of division and a lot of controversy and a lot of issues, is that issues over race, issues over religion, and issues over politics that bring a lot of issues to the world, excuse me, to the world as is. So, but, I mean, I still believe that black people's lives should matter. Yes, it's not that I don't. It's not that I don't find black women and black men attractive. It's not that I don't think their lives, you know, should matter and their lives, you know, are valuable. It's just the fact that I'm not putting myself towards a political movement, you know. I did actually recently write a Black Lives Matter poem, or at least I wrote a Black Lives Matter poem a few years ago, and then I had it just recently published through Hartford's Lit. But does that mean I'm going to stick with Black Lives Matter? No, it actually kind of doesn't. You know, there's obviously some changes of heart, you know, within the last and this year that obviously make me kind of want to not be a part of any political movement, including Black Lives Matter. Even though people say Black Lives Matter is the culturally acceptable, you know, movement that, you know, everybody is supporting because that is the way to go, you know. But yeah, my counselors say one thing and say another. And obviously some of these people who are obviously part of the, you know, these Black Lives Matter groups and these cultural groups in Hartford and stuff are all connected to, are kind of still connected to my counselors. You know, they're connected to my counselors, or they're connected to an agency that works with my counselors called Toivo. Toivo is a mental health agency that kind of does, you know, health and wellness type stuff. And there's a lot of people working for Toivo that are obviously part of the cultural group in Hartford that I've either had issues with or I was friends with and and had my own, you know, reasons for falling out with. But, you know, And then that's why I'm pissed, right? I'm pissed a little bit because I don't know if these people are going to become counselors. I mean, it doesn't necessarily mean that these people are going to become counselors, but obviously if you're working for Toivo, there's a good chance that you might end up showing your face in Torrington because you know, you work for Toivo, and, you know, Toivo actually has, you know, some people from Toivo have actually come to Torrington. I mean, I remember taking the Advocacy Unlimited class, and I remember meeting the people from Toivo at the time, and I remember meeting Calvin Young and people like that. So, but, I mean, I don't have issues with everybody who obviously is going to be working for Toivo or who has, but there are some people from the Hartford's cultural groups that obviously, you know, I've fallen out with because we've had clashes over Black Lives Matter and stuff like that, that now I think are gonna have a lot of nerve trying to become counselors or et cetera because they wanna take a job at Toivo and, you know, Toivo might make them a counselor and shit like that, so makes me kind of really pissed and upset that that's actually really happening, you know. Obviously, you know, this thing's personally and stuff that's happening kind of away from Toivo and stuff like that on, you know, through social media that have been happening on social media or have happened on social media that kind of have happened by them, you know, and they're all on their own with, you know, between me and, you know, some other people. But, you know, my counselors being my counselors, they'll be, you know, who knows if they're going to be like, oh, well, they took a job for you, and they're your counselors, and you're a client, and you got to deal with it, you know, it's like, you can deal with it my ass, you know, you guys, you know, Advocacy Unlimited is also supposed to be my actual lawyer, you know, I'm supposed to be a actual lawyer I can get, you know, if I needed something with, like, problems with, like, fair housing, or problems with my mental health issues, and stuff like that, but truthfully, there's been a lot of talk, too, about some things that have been happening and stuff like that. And so, for me, personally, I think in almost in some cases, I almost should be getting a real lawyer. I should almost be getting a real lawyer and also making people feel some type of heat because of certain situations and certain things that have been happening. But then again, you know, the state has been finding out about things through multiple people, not just myself. And I know a lot of other people have been talking too through like Toivo and, you know, and other people that I've either known or have known or do know or et cetera. There's a lot of things being said and a lot of things probably being said behind my back and et cetera that, you know, I wouldn't agree with. You know, there's a lot of things I wouldn't agree with that I probably wouldn't be very happy about, but you know, it's who's real to your face besides, you know, and real behind your back that really counts. If they're not really being real behind your back, then fuck them, you know. But regardless of the factor, you know, there's a lot of issues I have with these issues. And I think some people think I'm just being drama and stuff like that because I have some type of issue and I'm just trying to, you know, I'm just supposedly naturally racist or something because I, you know, because I've had issues with people over Black Lives Matter. It's not that I'm trying to be, you know, racist or anything because I'm not, you know. I believe that Black Lives Matter. I believe a black person's life should matter. I mean, you know, I just don't believe that I should be tied to the movement or the cause or anything related to, you know, the, you know, flying the black and white banner that I have in my kitchen, you know? So, but regardless of the factor, there's a big controversial issue coming up between, you know, the arts and the art, you know, the poetry and stuff that I wanted to keep separate from my recovery, you know, my recovery and my mental health program. I wanted to kind of keep the arts and, you know, the poetry and stuff separate from certain people and certain lot of individuals from the mental health program. Why? Because, you know, I've had issues in the past where people have come to events, you know, public events and stuff like that, and they've caused a lot of issues and stuff. Granted, a lot of those people went to jail, you know, and some people are trying to throw it up there in controversial, you know, talks that I should be one of those people who should have gone to jail and stuff like that because of, you know, things that have played out and et cetera. But, You know, I can't control other people. You know, the state can't control other people, but the clients were obviously responsible for the damages they created, and so a lot of some of those clients actually ended up going to jail and stuff, which they, you know, rightfully deserved. So, but the thing is, I don't want it to happen again. I don't want it to happen again in the arts. I don't want it to happen again when I'm trying to make, you know, an art, you know, a career for myself as a writer and as an artist and as somebody who is, you know, trying really hard to, you know, make something of himself, you know, as in the arts and the artist community, that, you know, I don't want my mental health or, you know, people who are only looking for to cause drama and shit to really get in the way of that. So I've always tried to make, you know, my mental health separate from the arts, although the arts, for me personally, on a personal level, has done a lot more to help me with my mental health sometimes than, you know, my own mental health program has, you know. But, you know, in a way, the arts and the mental health programs also work hand in hand, but they don't work hand in hand for me at the same time. I mean, obviously, I have my mental health programming, which is great. I have my artistry, which is great. But I wouldn't mix the two, only because, you know, it's mixed company. And, you know, when you get involved with, you know, people in mental health programs, some people are like, you know, some people are not really stable, and some people are, you know, cause drama and issues, and it's just not good for the overall picture of being an artist and trying to really do what you need to do. So, scratchy throat today. Oof. But regardless of the factor, you know, I might have to stop talking in a little bit. My throat's getting scratchy. But, you know, I wanted to keep the art, you know, the arts and my mental health very separate, although they both played a very big part in my life for two different reasons, you know. Granted, I don't do too many groups in my mental health. I don't do too many groups, you know, too many clinical groups or too many groups up at the office for my mental health. I found that, you know, there's only certain things I really need for my mental, you know, from my mental health agency. And then, you know, there's still a lot that, you know, the arts kind of brings to my life that, you know, that the mental health agency cannot, you know. Granted, when it comes to my art and being able to display and stuff like that, that's always been a big thing that I've always wanted to do. And I have, you know, so part of the reason why, you know, besides some issues that were very, you know, troubling and traumatizing to my mental health and et cetera, that's why I left certain programs for my mental health. Some of it also had to do with the lack of, you know, support and the lack of, you know, proper support that I felt would be worthy of my time as an artist and somebody of my artistic skill and my artistic skill level, that there's, you know, that I don't, I've left certain places because they weren't, you know, they weren't owning up to, you know, my level of worth. My level of worth. So, but at this point, you know, that's all I really gotta say, is that Black Lives should matter. You know, they should matter. I mean, obviously, I'm not gonna say that Black Lives matter as a movement or a cause, but I will say that Black people's lives should matter. I mean, obviously, you know, that's, you know, but I'm not gonna do it connected to the cause or the movement anymore, because I've had a lot of issues. No matter what I did, I had a lot of issues, and, you know, if you can't make somebody feel welcome or somebody feel like, you know, wanted to be part of your group, then I don't want to be a part of your group, you know? You can go fuck your group, you know? So, but anyways, I'm going to come back on for a part two. I'm going to get offline now and finish this salad and finish my drink, but anyways, hope all is well. Hope some of that made sense, you know, I hope some of that made sense of where I'm coming from, you know, And I think the state is playing a game. I think the state tells me one thing and then they say another thing to like their supervisors and stuff like that, or towards other people and stuff like that, when it really, you know, but really they're not being truthful to my face. So, you know, it happens. You know, the state wants to find out certain things, so they act like a certain way to your face and shit like that. Like they're your buddy and your friend, but really they're just trying to get into your business and stuff like that. Either for their own benefit or for their own sake of trying to make their jobs look good. So, just my life, huh? Anyways.